All right, I'm just gonna make this a quick video of me installing my internet modem. As you can see, the machine is out of service. And I got the package here, so we'll be opening this up and I'll go over what kind of modem I got, who I'm processing with, and we'll go from there. It's usually a pretty quick setup. I've already entered the master keys to the processor. So as soon as I hook up the internet, it should go ahead and start connecting and be ready to go. So here we go, I'll show you this right quick. So the internet is trying to, the ATM is trying to connect with the internet modem, but there's not any internet on this machine just yet. So it's still gonna search, and then it should pop up an error. It's gonna pop up an error. Test print is okay, so we're all good there. But we'll see. I'm gonna see what error it shows. But it should say something to the effect of TCI, IP, no connection. So now it's trying to connect to the internet. So we'll just wait and see. But like I said, it's no internet connected, so it should not connect to any internet right now. It usually takes about a minute. All right, there he is. Out of service, ATM is temporary out of service, error code, TCP, IP, connection, timeout. So pretty much that's an error code saying that the machine is trying to connect to the internet, but it's not having any success. So that's pretty much what that is. So we'll get started on hooking up the internet. Process through ATM Depot. And so that's pretty much how I work through. Alright, and this is pretty much a 4G modem. That's through T-Mobile. And I'll post a link to it so you can see it. They got different kinds. This is pretty much it right here. It's real small. I mean, pretty much, I have small hands, so it can fit like in the palm of my hand almost. It's very small. And you can place this like, you know, either at the bottom or pretty much at the top, because the antenna's got to go above, on top of the ATM. So this is it right here. That's pretty much the connections here. Ethernet cable, power, two antennas. That's where they go, where the gold spots are. And I'm not gonna use that right there. So, like I said, power supply, Ethernet cable, and two antennas. These are some brackets. The SIM card, this acts pretty much just like a cell phone. That's all this is pretty much a cell phone. So, but it's actually like an internet modem. So it has a SIM card on the inside of it. And pretty much, I guess they just gave us some extras. But the SIM card is just like, if you remember how the old cell phones used to be with T-Mobile, and they probably still are, you put the SIM card in it and then you slide it into the slot right there. And actually, I think I'll show you that real quick. So pretty much like I was saying, it's a little slot right here, and there's a SIM card. So that's the programming, and it acts just like a cell phone. Put the SIM card in, slide it back into that slot right there. And then those two or three bars will light up once we get everything going. So once we get everything going, you'll see everything lights up, and it'll connect to the internet. So that's pretty much everything we need. Got the modem, got the two antennas, got the internet cable, and power supply. We won't need these. I guess those are just extras for whatever reason. Well, if I have multiple SIM cards, and won't really need the brackets right now. I'm just setting it up. The brackets right now is pretty much more to secure the box inside the ATM. But I don't think I need that. All right. So the first thing I'm gonna hook up is the power supply. So. And pretty much right here, I have a, I'll hook it into that extension cord and then I'll just run it up through to the top here. And that's how the back of it. So I'll run it up to that cable right there. Not in the cable, but I'll just run it through that hole right there. And I'll store the internet box somewhere in here. Or I could do it at the bottom, but I'm just gonna show you real quick. So you see, I'm just gonna run it right through that little hole right there. Then it's gonna come out up top for the power supply. All right, so we got it up through the top. So I pretty much got it up through the top now. See, there it is. I just got that. I'm just gonna, like I said, I'm not gonna leave it like this. I'm just setting up the internet so you can see how easy it is just to set it up to get it going. Then after that, I can put it back down in there or wherever, wherever I'm gonna put it. So. So it'll start powering on. Next, we gotta plug in the Ethernet connection to the machine right here. And this is the old, well, this is the one that if you had a landline, you'll put it in and it goes out the back. But since we're not using the landline, we're using the internet connection, we disconnected that and then we'll put ours in here. And it'll go right into the machine. So this is pretty much, it's identical to the one right there. So all we're gonna do is just plug it in right there, right above where it says the phone line. It just goes right to the left of the phone line. You push it in, you hear it click, and then good to go. And there's a one hand. Click it in there. So it's linking up. All the other functions, you gotta give it time to boot up, and soon these will light up. But let me go ahead and hook up that. The last part is the antennas. So we'll hook those up. And these are the antennas right here. And this is magnetic, so it'll just stick to the ATM. It'll just cling on and stick right there. You just have to hook up the antenna to it. And pretty much all you're doing, you're just hooking that up. I'm sorry. You're just hooking that in right there and then twisting it. And that's pretty much it. Like that part is sticking on the top. And then you put that into the modem. So like I said, this is magnetic. It'll stick right to it. So put that in. Then I'm just gonna screw that in right there, and then I get the other one and screw it in on the other side. Screw it in, make sure you screw it in nice and tight. And then we'll get the other side. All right, so we got everything plugged in on the back. Got the two antennas, got an internet cable, and a power supply all at the end of this right here. Got the SIM card going. So you got two bars right now, two or three bars, and it was pretty good. You only got three options anyway. So green light is linking, no warnings. Power supply is on because it's red, and then the status, that's always gonna blink. And then, like I say, if you're unsure of anything, it comes with an instruction guide, or you can contact, like I said, since I went with ATM Depot, all I had to do is call the technician, and they walk me through whatever I gotta, you know, whatever I need. But for the most part, this is it right here. And like I said, after I make sure the internet is gonna get that error off of there for the, we're saying now that the door is open, but once I get everything rebooted, I'll cut it off, cut it back on, get everything rebooted, and then it'll be in service. So that's pretty much it. Like I said, I already installed the master keys to the processor so it can link up with that. So I'll show a video on that when I get done with this. I'll probably shoot a video for that, just showing how to set it up. But it's real easy. I mean, installing this, everything's already done. Once you get to this part, installing whatever the codes are, it's pretty easy. I mean, I'm pretty tech savvy, but even if you weren't tech savvy, I mean, it's not hard at all. So it's no different from hooking up a cable box. So, all right. So let's get this thing rebooted. And like I said, it's a reboot switch right here on the power switch right here, or you can just unplug it. So either way. So I'll just hit that there. Gonna go off. And pretty much just like rebooting a computer. It usually takes a couple of minutes to reboot, just like a computer. It's gonna say temporary out of service until it starts to try to connect to the internet. So once that screen goes off, it'll try to configure that, okay, internet is hooked up, and then it'll just start searching for it. So now I was trying to search for the internet. Yeah, send out a test page, make sure everything's all right. So it gave me this error that the door is still open. So I still have the door open, so I'll have to close the door. All right, so close the door. So now it goes back to configuring the internet. You have to do a health check, and boom, there you go. Welcome to Affiliate Mobile ATM. Please insert your card. Internet is going. I got one more, but that doesn't really make a difference. It'll go between 1, 2, and 3, just based on the network and where you are. So, but if you get this screen and no errors, then you're all good to go. Like I say, I've already set up the keys and all the programming to it. So it was just as simple as me just hooking up the internet and going in. So that's pretty much it. I'm gonna post another video on just going into like some of the options in there when you program and stuff, how to get to that screen. I mean, you can have it say anything that you wanted to say. If you got a barbershop, you can put the barbershop's name on it. You can say whatever, welcome, have a nice day, you know, whatever promotions or marketing you want to put on there. So that's it. Let me see if I can put my prepaid card in there and see if it give us a balance. All right, so I have a Cash App card here. So I'm just gonna stick it in and see if I can get a balance on it. I hardly ever use it, so should be a zero balance on it, but still we can check it. So plug it in, and this is how you know it's working. It wouldn't even get to this point if it wasn't working. And you put in your PIN code. Would you like to check your balance? Yes. I don't charge for checking balances. Some ATMs do. They do charge you just to check it, but I'm not doing that. So the owner of this ATM does not charge a fee for a balance inquiry, but your financial institution may charge a fee. So your bank may actually even charge you a fee for not even using their bank. Even though I'm not charging a fee just for you to use to check the balance, your bank will probably. So it depends. So we'll just go with checking. Would you like to receive a receipt? You can do a digital receipt where it goes to like maybe a website or something like that. No receipt, paper receipt, we'll do that. So it's connecting to the internet. It's trying to connect to your bank to see if you got any funds, or it's gonna let you know how many funds you do have. And it's gonna print. And then I get a notification from my bank as soon as I do it. And then, boom, there it is. Zero balance, zero available. Would you like another transaction? Sure. You know, reconnect to the bank. Had to press enter your code in again. Hit enter. Let's say a little draw. It might say, I'm pretty sure it's gonna say I have insufficient funds because it's a zero balance, but still. How would you like to receive a receipt? Let me get a paper receipt. Which account? Checking, savings, or credit card? Let's do checking. And then $20 surcharge fee. That's what I'm, well, not surcharge fee, but that's how much you can withdraw. I haven't added in either any other options because all I have is $20 bills in this machine. So you do 20. And then boom, Affiliate Mobile ATM. It charge you $3 surcharge fee. And then if I was to click yes, ATM would give me out the money, the $20, the customer, the $20, and then I would get repaid $23 with my money and then the surcharge fee. So that's pretty much how that works. And I'm gonna hit no because I know I don't have any money in there, so. So once that's over, it'll just say, please remove your card. Get your card out of there. Well, time was over, so. Then it goes back to the home screen. And then like I say, it's ready for the next transaction. And that's pretty much it. I mean, hooking up the internet, probably literally only took me like 5 minutes, really. I mean, self-explanatory. You're just hooking up the antennas, the power cord, and the internet cord. And then that cord goes into the computer of the ATM. And then, like I say, the processor will give you the master key so it can go back and forth with your processor and then process the charges. Alright. Oh, don't forget to subscribe to the page. And like I say, join the group if you're not in the group. I got a lot of free training. Got a course out now, so check all those things out. And like I say, I'm gonna put this out, and then it's gonna make me money.